Hey, furries. If you don't know, my name is Gnarlsby.
It's Gnarlsby, the art house film director that ripped my ear.
I told Spigots I'd help him with his vloggist video every day thing, but he had to agree to let me put up my new art house short film as the video for today. Some of you may have seen my previous work here on the channel. I'll put links right here and right here, and of course down in the description. I shot this new film, Toothpaste, to premiere specifically in art houses and in the living rooms of people who would understand and get it. The only reason I'm posting it up here is simply because of the economics of the situation. I don't really have distribution yet. Hopefully people might see it up here, maybe 20 people, who knows, anyway. So here is my new film. I'm incredibly proud of it. Some of you might get it, most of you probably won't, but it's called Toothpaste.
Councils of government, we must guard against the acquisition of unwarranted influence, whether sought or unsought, by the military-industrial complex. The potential for the disastrous rise of misplaced power exists and will persist. We must never let the weight of this combination endanger our liberties or democratic processes. Today, the solitary inventor, tinkering in his shop, has been overshadowed by task forces of scientists in laboratories and testing fields. In the same fashion, the free university, historically the fountainhead of free ideas and scientific discovery, has experienced a revolution in the conduct of research, partly because of the huge costs involved. A government contract becomes virtually a substitute for intellectual curiosity. For every old blackboard, there are now hundreds of new electronic computers. The prospect of domination of the nation's scholars by federal employment, project allocations, and the power of money is ever present and is gravely to be regarded. Yet in holding scientific research and discovery in respect, as we should, we must also be alert to the equal and opposite danger that public policy could itself become the captive of a scientific, technological elite.